أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين All praise is due to Allah who has created man and has not left him but indeed has given him guidance as to that which is liked by the Creator and he has commanded upon man struggle with consciousness and awareness in his behalf It is with this in mind that we see that the trust that has been given to man is always dispatched, for again, the Creator has commissioned. He has commissioned the soldier to fight, to jihad, the teacher to teach, the organizer to organize. And for the Muslim, he has commanded that we invite, that we give an invitation. And the invitation, again, is based and centered around that you invite people to the consciousness and awareness that struggle is an ongoing process. For Allah has said in the Quran, He has created man to toil and struggle. The word that is used in the Quran for struggle is kabad, which gives a general sense of struggle, meaning that everything and everyone who comes into this life engages in struggle to survive. The baby, when he is born, He transforms from breathing a liquid into breathing a gas. It is said that when the egg is fertilized, there's a competition between the sperm for fertilization of the egg. And this is implanted upon the individual himself, so he knows the nature of struggle. But then Allah in the Quran commands a higher level of struggle, for he says, into jihad, fi sabilillah, to struggle with an awareness and a consciousness. And so it is that kind of struggle that distinguishes the people, those people whose commitment allows them to honor the trust, to become conscious and aware, and to struggle in a manner in which they first deal with themselves, and then that which emanates from dealing with yourself begins to involve the environment. That is the social context of struggle. And it is a struggle that is the higher form of struggle. So there is a sense of commitment that we make as individuals, and we ask the Creator with consciousness to guide our heart and to guide our tongue. We seek refuge in Him from misleading and from being misled, from betraying and being betrayed into ignorance by others. And on the basis of this commitment, we are able to distinguish those people who have made similar kinds of commitments. For indeed, in struggle and war, there is a kind of camaraderie that is forged in war. In the heat of war. So therefore, the communications are shortened between those people who struggle on that level. I don't need to come and tell you a whole lot about Kwame. It is evident, for Allah has allowed him to struggle in a manner that is clear to the people. Blessed are those who struggle. Oppression is worse than the grave. He said it is better to live and fight for a noble cause than to live and die a slave. And it, again, it is with this understanding and awareness in this context that we begin to understand those people who were propelled, not just Kwame, and Kwame being, you know, a leading figure from an era of movement and struggle. But the people whose names that Kwame may know and I don't know, and who other people know and other people might not know, it is that sense of struggle that Kwame has committed himself to, not that as we come forth and give applause or that we say things kind about him. Because with myself and Kwame, there are certain things that we can say in the shortest of forms that has a deep meaning. Because again, we have similar experiences in struggle. But we do extend an invitation to Kwame and to all creation that there is a level of commitment and consciousness that you have to make in struggle to be able to be successful, to take it from one level to another. How do we bring about good people? Again, when we look at ourselves in the context of the 60s, we see one of the major shortcomings was that we were emulating the people that we were fighting against. Our morals and our ethics were the morals and ethics that were taught by the people who we fought against. How do you raise a people? How do you, again, bring about a consciousness and awareness amongst humanity that makes them strive for the best. And again, it begins with ourselves. If you can't beat yourself, you can't beat nobody else. Everybody can fight, but everybody can't win. There's a discipline, there's a price that is paid to win. So the Creator, in not leaving us alone to figure out worship, has instructed us concerning worship. He says to be a better person, one has to be able to commit himself to a practice. It says prayer five times a day, for prayer restrains and keeps you from bad behavior. Fasting during the month of Ramadan, for it teaches you self-restraint and discipline. Charity, because you will not have believed until you want for your brothers what you want for yourselves. And Hajj, because it is that sense of community and pilgrimage that makes us aware that all come from two. And Allah says in the Quran, all come from two. And He has created the races that men might get to know each other, not that they would hate each other. The best amongst you is he who is most righteous. The companions of the Prophet asked him, what is righteousness? He said, good behavior. He said, of the things that will make you successful, there are two. Taqwa Allah wal husna khuluq. That is consciousness of the Creator and your ability to do good, to have good behavior. It is this sense of struggle that we left the 60s with, and we continue with an awareness that struggle has not stopped. It didn't begin in the 50s and end in the 70s. If our analysis of struggle is that it began in the 50s and ended in the 70s, then there is a total failure of closure on the part of our struggle that we are involved in. Again, no, the movement sense of struggle, which has always visited struggle. It says that the anti-slavery movement, Marcus Garvey movement, the Black Power movement, Civil Rights movement, they come and they go. But the struggle is continuous until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has righted the wrong that has come about. Again, may Allah be pleased with the effort that has been put forth by all of the people who have struggled here. And again, with Kwame, that he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised him and that Allah has commanded in terms of a higher level of struggle from him. And that Allah will allow him to understand the importance in this life of making the declaration concerning that which is truth. And that Allah will allow him to understand in terms of that when Allah begins to move us from one condition to another, it's for a reason. And it's a mercy that he gives us time to reflect and to grow. So again, we ask Allah for a look that is merciful, a knowledge that is useful, a heart that is enlightened, a tongue that is truthful, an intellect that is unerring, a countenance that is pleasing to Allah. And may Allah give us success in this life and in the hereafter. May He raise us in the company of the righteous. May Allah allow the invitation that has been given to be accepted. As-salamu alaykum.